Doesn't speak Spanish, so I will do my lecture in English. So I hope everybody will understand what I'm talking about. My talk is about learning, and of course it's learning at schools, learning from children, but we still learn. I think I'm still learning. We don't stop learning when we leave the schools. And I hope you will learn something today, and I will learn something today from you, from what's happening in Spain. When you design schools, you start to go back to your own school. We have to point it. This was my school, where it was in a village in the south of Holland. It's a building from 1916, and it was a school only for boys in these days. So things are changed. My talk is about changes. It's a building from 1916, and it's not in any book on architecture. It's just a building. It's architecture, but it's not in books on architecture. What is special is that the classrooms are much higher than they are now, so over 4 meters. And we were with 50 kids in that classroom, and nowadays maximum in Holland is 30. But in fact, the attic for me was the most exciting place. So the roof, under the roof was a mystical place where you only were allowed to go when you were in the last class. And I was there some years ago, and now it's not a school anymore. It's a place to live, for housing. And what is so funny, that the people who are living there were also there at school, but then maybe 50 years before. And then I was wondering, what will happen with the buildings we are building now? Is it possible over 100 years to live there? Or are they not schools anymore and broken down? Since I was at school, a lot of things has been changed. So the traditional classroom will disappear. The groups will become smaller. And more there will be individual teaching. And there is space needed for that as well. So in Holland, we have not only a teacher, but we have also assistants. So there is not only one person for a class, but there are maybe three for two classes. So we need spaces which vary in size, so we can make larger spaces or smaller spaces. So this is a picture of a school I did with a sliding wall between two classrooms. Now we have a beamer, not a blackboard anymore. And also the task of the school is changing. The school buildings in Holland have more a social function also for the neighborhood. So they become our new churches, what they say. So the churches in Holland are empty. So we need new churches, and the schools which are in the middle of a neighborhood can have this social function. They also have daycare centers, so you enter school not at the age of 6 or 4, but already when you are 1 year old. So that means that you are in the building from your first year until your 12th. And I was in this building from my 6th to my 12th. So the period a child is in the same building is very long. It's 11 years. And I was only a few hours in the school, but children today stay longer because their parents work and they stay in the building until 5:30. So in this schedule, I try to show you that from the age from 4 to 12, and in fact it's from 1 to 12, in the brown period I was at school, and in the orange blocks, it's today's child. And then you have to add also the evening programs in school. My school was empty in the evenings, but today schools will be used for adult education, for instance, and sports. So the buildings have to function 4 times more intensive than 50 years ago, 4 times more intensive. But the quality of the buildings is not 4 times better, maybe even worse than the traditional buildings, which were very well made. So that gave me an idea how should we maybe design new buildings, maybe better look to the past. I think a good school building must be a compact building, because a compact building is economical and we should not spend too much money on the buildings but only to education. So not atypical forms, but just a very rational form. A compact building is also better for the energy. So when you are in Holland, it's much colder than here, and when it's cold, you will to become as small as possible to lose, not to lose energy. The examples I show you is a school I did in The Hague. The construction should also be very simple, so you can change as much as possible in the interior. So in this school building, we used load-bearing facades. So there are no load-bearing walls between the classrooms, but the load-bearing walls are in the facade, so you are more free to adapt spaces to the functions. And in this building, it's designed for a school. It is also designed with the school itself. So I designed it with the teachers. So in Holland, we are free for every school to design a separate typical building. So we have no standard schools. But for the future, maybe there are not enough children. So this building is adaptable for instance, housing, as in my old school. Or you can make an office in it. So one classroom can be a small apartment. A good school should have a central flexible space as a meeting point for children, but also for adults, because it's a meeting point for adults. And I think that is very important for the social structure in the city and in the neighborhoods. Adults should meet at schools. But also not in the building, only in the building, but also outside the building. So they are waiting for their children, and they start to talk with each other. And my schools, I designed for very difficult neighborhoods, very social difficult neighborhoods, and I think the contact between these parents is very important. But the classroom should stay the home for the children, because they are so long in this building, from 9 o'clock in the morning until 5:30, and for 11 years, so it is their second home. A model we use often in Holland is this model where we create a flexible structure. It's a structure with 4 classrooms, which have each a smaller space for individual teaching, but we can transform this simple scheme. So we can make a central space which can be used by one of the classes or by all the classes together. Also, you can combine two classrooms to make a bigger room for special events. And it is even possible to make one big room so you can combine the classes with the central space. Also, the corridors, if you have to make them, sometimes the form of the building has needs corridors, you can use them also for smaller education areas. The materials inside should be easy to maintain. In Holland, there are a lot of new school buildings, completely white, painted, and after 2 months, they look awful. So go back to the traditional ideas about making walls that you can easy maintain. Because a functional building can also be a beautiful building. Here we use a lot of tiles in the building. It's very simple, it's not new, but we have forgotten a lot of these simple rules. This is the outside of the school building in The Hague, and the outside should be strong because it should last for 50 or maybe 100 years, this building. And strong can be beautiful. We have a lot of nice bricks in Holland, and I like to use the bricks because this material is very strong and beautiful. But also the architecture should be permanent and not fashionable. So architecture nowadays has become a fashion. And I think a building should be a fashion for 100 years. So that is different from what you see in the magazines. I will show you quickly some schools. I start with the school in The Hague you have seen in the slides before. So this is the entrance of the school with a small bench on the outside. And this is the section. The most important element spatially is a central stair which goes from the ground floor to the top floor like a cascade. You also see it's a very compact building with the gymnasium incorporated in the building. It's the green element in the section. And there are some multifunctional spaces as well. In the same idea, I did a school in Rotterdam. And there was not a gymnasium, but a bigger sports hall placed on top of the building. So the spaces we have in the cities are very narrow and very tight, so you have to make compact buildings and most of the times for on more floors. So here you see the school building with the sports hall on top, and there are also other functions in the same building. So the sports hall is also for people in the area. A just finished building is this school. This is in a traditional neighborhood. So I try to react on the traditional architecture in this area. And I put the gymnasium on top under a roof. So it looks a little bit like my old school in 1916. So here you see the section. You see under the roof is a big playroom for the smaller children and a gymnasium. These are pictures of the housing which is connected to the school and of the daycare center which was not in use at the time of the picture, which was the opening was last week. Very quickly, three schools I'm doing now. A school in Amsterdam on two floors, which has very simple plans, but the same idea of combining four classrooms around a corridor. And also there is, for instance, a healthcare center for the neighborhood incorporated. I also working in Belgium. In Belgium, there is a huge new school program. the government of Flanders, I say Belgium, but in fact it's Flanders, has a very interesting program. You should maybe try to find this on the internet. And I start with this very small school, and what is interesting is that the central space can be used as a theater. So you see, you have an image of the central space with the curtains, and it can be used as a theater for the school, but also for the village. Another school in Belgium is this school, which has also a very large community center. So here the school building on the right side is connected with the community center. So this is an image. The building is not yet under construction, but will be constructed next year. So I hope I can learn something from you. So I'm very curious about to hear all the questions and about the situation in Spain and maybe also in London from my colleague. Thank you very much.